for all the technologies. Okay.
Okay.
Now each technology, now you keep on adding
your screen.
Yeah. You want to screen share, right?
Yes.
Okay. Can you see now?
Yes.
Okay. Now you created chapter 4 for trunks, right? VTP VLANs. Same way, chapter 5, chapter 6, chapter 7, up to 20 chapters are there, no?
Yes.
Just sit and do, like, whenever your free time is coming, you just update this Word file and send it to me. Okay. Then you can add some, in the same file, you can add the commands also. After you finish this activity, you can add for this, what command will come? For mismatch, what are the show commands? What is the verification commands, you know?
Okay, sir.
So chapter 3, 4 you did, no? Chapter 2, chapter 1. Chapter 1, 3, what is the commands you can write down?
Okay.
Got it now?
Yes, sir.
Your notes, you can keep it. So tomorrow, when you're doing the labs, right, troubleshooting, you can open and see this file and see what command to be typed to verify.
Yes, sir.
You got an idea, no?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So this is done. Now let us start the activity. Now what we finished is, now we have finished about the theory part of troubleshooting. Now we are going to do labs. Okay.
Okay.
So I have enterprise infrastructure. Yeah. Okay. So this is the topology. I will send this topology to you. Okay. Now what do you do? This is the topology. Can I see the topology?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I will send this topology.
Okay.
I think it will come in email, right? Let me see.
Can send it on Skype also, sir.
Skype also?
Yeah.
Let's see. Skype. Yeah. Email is better because you can track it down. Skype means search, na? I'll reply further. Because you have email, no? No problem, no?
Yes, sir.
Because the reason is I can track it down, what you have done. Like a record, it will be there. Same location. Follow. Okay. So now security, CCIE, NIR. Security, enterprise, infrastructure, terms, CCNP, practice, programming. Okay. Okay, what I'm giving now is a simple working topology.
Okay.
Okay. I sent you that. You can download and open it.
Okay.
So you can open that. And what we need to do from this topology is, the first activity for you is, you need to open. Let us write down this. The first and foremost, as I told you, system study. Okay, now first thing, troubleshooting approach. T-shoot approach. Tell me, what is your approach? How do you troubleshoot?
First, we see what is the problem.
Problem report.
Yes.
Then
we collect information.
Now here, when you gather information or collect information, right?
Yes.
Now we are going to discuss on this. Now they are not giving you any information. You need to go and collect yourself.
Okay.
They are saying, we don't have any information, we don't have any document, any topology diagram, anything. You can come and collect from yourself. So you are going and collecting the information. So what all the information you need to collect? Now this is the topology. What is the topology? Close it down. Yeah. So This is the topology. Okay.
Okay.
Now this topology, they told you this is the topology. You please come and collect yourself.
Okay.
Understand now?
Yes.
Now, what is we need to do is we need to go and understand lot of things from this topology, because before troubleshooting, I need to know lot of what are things I need to know. First, L1 information. We'll go as a model, we'll follow.
Okay.
L1 information, what all things you need to collect. Second, L2 information, what are things you need to collect. And L3 information, what are things you need to collect. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Just tell me, like, what all things you want to collect from physical layer. Physically, just seeing by physically.
And the wires are connected or not? Line cables.
What are that?
The cables.
Cables, okay. What cables, okay, fine. Then cable after that? Just then, like, okay, huh?
The device, the entire device is working or not?
Not working, collecting information. I am just collecting all the information now.
Okay, how many routers and all are there? Routers.
Router, what in router what you collect?
Sorry, sir?
What you collect in the router? What you want collect, what information you want to collect from the router?
Which router is placed where?
Information. Okay, I'll write down like this. First thing what I'll collect is topology diagram.
Okay.
Topology and the logical topology diagrams. Okay. I'll ask them if you have any diagrams, share with me.
Okay.
Like we may have physical topology, logical topology, you know. For example, in this diagram, if you see, in this this is there, right? Numbers are there. For example, think like this. Go to options. Always short level you off it. And the link also you off it. Now see, this is your topology. And fine, na?
Yeah.
For example, they're giving like this. Okay, they're like this. Nothing is there.
Okay.
Think like this. Okay, now keep like this. Nothing is there. If it is like this, so what do you do? You got my idea, now?
Yes, sir.
So I'll take a screenshot of this. This is the topology they are giving. Who's giving?
The organization is very.
They are saying this is the topology we have. That's it. They're not sharing anything extra, anything less. So this is the topology we have. You need to collect information from this.
Okay.
Now, in this information also not there. I'm just removing all the information. Think like this. Okay, real time mein aise rahega, you know?
Okay.
Nothing will be available. Like this, they'll give you some diagram like this. Something. Okay. Got the idea, na?
Yes, sir.
Now, how do you find out all these things if this diagram is not available? Understand the point?
Yes, sir.
How do you build all these things? Tell me. How do you create this topology first?
Go and check, so.
You want to travel to, for example, this is in Australia, this is in New Zealand. We'll go to New Zealand, huh?
No. Give CDP commands and check. Yes.
So this is the first option, discovery protocols.
Okay.
Okay. So basically you need to have interview with people. Okay.
Okay.
And talking to the people, they may be knowing all these things. They may not be having diagrams in hand, but sit with them and understand them and create a topology and show them. See, okay. Is this the topology? Are you working now? Is it correct, right, wrong? Can you review and tell me? Then you collect that information from that interview.
Okay.
Just interview, and whatever you collected, you start updating in your topology diagram. Like I removed so many things here, right? So all these things you have to manually understand and update. See, this is our L3 information, EHRP, you know?
Yes, sir.
L3 information, HSRP. See, HSRP configured here, virtual IP. Both channels are configured, Ether channels are configured, VLANs are configured. I'm removing all these things.
Okay.
Got my idea, right?
Yes, sir.
So real time, they are not ready to share anything. They don't have any document like this. They generally don't know what IP address also configured. BGP also I'm removing. NAT I'm removing, IPv4 NAT. Okay.
Mm.
Now they're just telling you this is the configuration we have. And these are some IP addresses we know. Now what you'll do? Understand the question?
Yes, sir.
So this, if they give like this, no? First of all, you need to understand this physical topology. Forget about configuration. There are two PCs, one, three server, two servers.
Mm.
How many routers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 routers.
5 routers.
4 switches. Some internet connections are there. Some, you know, so many connections are, WAN connections are there. This you have to understand. This is physical topology.
Okay.
Then logically, you need to sit and understand. This is the first activity you have to do when you go for a troubleshooting. If you really not, take a paper and pen and draw this diagram if they don't have.
Okay.
First step, when you want to do troubleshooting, take a paper and pen, draw the topology, physical topology.
Okay.
Physically, how the devices are connected, what network I'm going to troubleshoot.
Hmm.
This is the first activity you do. Second activity, understand the cables and connectors. Okay. What technology you're using, cables and connectors you're using, and the model, make and model.
Okay.
Right now?
Yeah.
Make and model. Then you go for. You got it, na?
Yes, sir.
So these things you collect is first information. This is your first. In our case, I'm giving you the topology in hand by default, right? But you just, you have to learn how to find out. So you need to do using packet tracer. How do you find out one by one? So you, as you told you, the answer is CDP.
Hmm.
And interview. Everything is not in CDP. Something you have to ask people also who are managing it. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so the answer is collect information, do some interview, and if you have SNMP console. SNMP console is NMS. NMS means what?
Network.
Network management system.
Yes.
So these softwares will actually built automatically. They will use CDP protocol. They will automatically create this topology.
Okay.
In this tool, if you go and see, there is an option called topology. If you click the topology, it will show you what topology it is maintaining.
Yeah.
So NMS will give you. So NMS from NMS, you collect some raw data or just diagrams or anything, can use it. This is the first one. Now second, what you collect L2 information?
Is data link clear?
Yeah, L2 using OSI model.
So we basically check for the routing tables and stuff.
Routing is L2, huh?
No, the tables.
Table name, information. How to do it? That is next issue. What you want to collect for our L2?
The switches we check.
And the switch is okay. So what information you want? What are the L2 technologies?
Mac media access control.
Mac, okay. In Mac, what do you check? Mac is a layer, right? Media access control layer.
LAN, Ethernet. LAN, sir.
What information you want in L2? Now, just know you return, na?
Yes.
Just know you return in chapter 4, what are information you wrote?
Trunk.
That all comes in L1 or L2 or L3?
L2.
Yeah, so switch, na? Switch related things all are L2, right?
Yes.
VLAN. Trunk. VTP. Right, what else? STP. PBSTP. No, you know, right?
Yes, sir.
What is running? STP is running, PBSTP is running, RSTP is running. Right now?
Yes.
RSTP, RSP, RST, and MST is running. What is running in the switch? But all you have to collect, no?
Yes.
And what type of they are doing, like FHRP? Is what? Redundancy protocol, no? L3 redundancy, which they configure. VRRP, GLBP. What are they? HSRP?
Yes.
These things. Anything else you want to capture from that? L2?
Switching port. No.
MAC addresses, if you want to capture. MAC address, you know? MAC addressing. And L2 security. You have done any L2 security, you know?
Yes.
Like MAC filtering, all these things, no? Switch port security. Somebody will block, no? Switch port.
Yes.
Something like that. So there are so many things are there. I'm just writing to make you to understand, right? What is L2 information? Now L3, what do you capture first?
IP address.
First is IP address. Now the problem with IP addressing is there are two IP addressing is there. One is IPv4 and the other one is?
V6.
IPv6.
V6.
Now what you do? You take a paper and pen, open this this diagram, disable, how I disable, you know, everything. Like this, disable everything in that lights and everything, whatever possible, disable it. And try to learn all these things by commands, show commands.
Okay.
You understand now?
Yes, yes.
So this is a very, very important task for troubleshooting. If you really don't know what VLAN is running, which port is connected to which VLAN, what is Ether channel is running. We didn't return Ether channel, no? So Ether channel is important, right?
Yes.
L3 Ether channel is there. What else? Inter VLAN routing, you know?
So that will come in VLAN only, no?
Inter VLAN.
Okay.
VLAN comes where? VLAN is L2 or L3?
L2.
Yeah, you can keep it like this. So basically inter VLAN routing. Here what we are discussing is Rotron stick, not RIP EHRP OSPF routing, okay?
Okay.
L3 switching, Rotron stick. Here we are discussing what? Rotron stick, that topic, okay?
Okay.
You can put anywhere, doesn't matter, but you need to capture somewhere, that's it. But here, why I'm putting here is, the reason is, basically this is big routing, VLAN traffic. When you're learning, you have to learn one shot. You cannot learn half off, no?
Yes.
When you learn, understand switching, route, VLANs. You need to learn, there are 5 VLANs are there. How the VLANs are connected, you have to know, right?
Yes.
That all comes under inter VLAN routing. Clear, no?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the one. After this, what are the things you have to verify? I think anything else you want to add? You have to?
L3 router and stick.
I think L2 enough, right?
Yes.
We'll see. We'll keep on adding it. It doesn't matter, right? Whenever you learn, you add extra things. Now, in L3, we'll go to L3. Okay. I want to add one more to L2 also. Okay. What is L2? WAN. WAN protocols are L2, you know, right? Do you know that?
No, sir.
WAN is L1 and L2 only. There is no L3 WAN.
Okay.
When the packet is moving from LAN to WAN, L1, L2 will change.
Okay.
So all your WAN details will come in L2 only.
Okay.
Like for example, here we have, frame relay. Frame relay is there in this topology?
Yes.
So all these details, Delsi numbers?
Correct.
What are the DLC numbers are there? What are the PVCs are there? This all you will learn in L2 only. So in L2, so many things you have to capture. So how do you capture this? How do you learn all these things?
show commands.
Yes, using show commands. Right? So you can learn all these things just by show commands. Okay?
Yeah.
Here you use interview, but you can use, here it's not possible only show commands, because everything is not possible in show commands. Interview is must. Physical, na?
Yeah.
Visit is must, possible. Whichever visit you can do it. Understand? Now yes. L3 also we can use show commands. Is it right?
Yeah.
Clear, na? Next.
Yes.
L3. Routing protocols?
Yes.
What else?
Then RIP. EIGRP.
OSPF is there. And we have BGP also somewhere.
Yes.
In these three. Anything else?
Then also finding that CF and all will come in that only L3, right?
CF, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, CF is basically to protect your CPU. Right, that is, this information is mandatory to capture. Yeah, can capture. See, what you can do is all the technologies you can divide like this.
Okay.
Now, you are writing all the technologies in a letter by word file, na?
Yes.
The word file you write down, then you finally you develop, after you finish that all the technologies are written in the word file. Mm-hmm. After that you create one sheet, after that next sheet you write down like this, divide that into layers.
Okay.
All the technologies divide into different layers, you know, so you understand what layer we are actually. You have a clarity. Then if anything wrong, I'll correct that. You can show me that, you can send me that, okay?
Yes.
This you can create as a next sheet.
Okay.
Before commands, you know.
Yes.
So we'll make one sheet like this. One is, first is what are the technologies. Second is how do, what is your approach. Third is I'll teach you how to create document diagrams now.
Okay.
Policy diagrams. So you can use WordFile, Paint. You know, you can use your PowerPoint also.
Okay.
Or you can just draw in your paper and pen and put it in the WhatsApp and paste it as a Paint file. You know.
Yes, sir.
Not able to draw in the PowerPoint, you can draw in the paper and pen also. It's okay. You can take a photo and put it in the WhatsApp. In the WhatsApp, you take it and send it in the copy paste in the file, the Word file. Possible, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So any method, but I like to put some topologies also after this. Now, tell me any other details. Infrastructure services. What are the services you know? ACL, NAT. See. Remember, infrastructure services is a services which is useful to run the network. It is not that customer or user may be knowing it, these services. Okay. It is not directly interacting with these services. Backend it is running. Understand, no?
Yes, sir.
So these things you need to know, right? These details.
Yes.
DNS, DHCP, what else? NTP. Okay. And you can put this as a service here also.
Okay.
I removed it now. I put it here. FHRP. It's all services actually, you know?
Yes.
Services. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
These services are not directly seen by the customer or user.
Okay.
So user may not be knowing it, but back end without that services, your network will not, your infrastructure will not work. So that type of services, what we call? Infrastructure services.
Okay.
Understand this difference?
Yes.
Now I'm writing down some services which we did studied in this in real time. There are something like directory services. Windows, if you heard about this, directory services. That is also part of directory. Right?
Yes.
It is for ADS, Active Directory Services, LDAP. Okay. And Kerberos. Kerberos spelling kya? Oh, Kerber authentication process. Kerberos. Correct, na? Kerberos. Like the different services are there. AAA. Okay. Identity service engine. I can keep on writing. Just I'm not going to confuse you, but I'm telling you, apart from this, so many services are required to run your day-to-day activities, which we generally don't consider to be user be knowing it.
Okay.
But user may be using day-to-day some services.
Yes.
That is called applications.
Okay.
Users are, what are the applications daily user will use? Email. Daily use, right? The user, the end user.
Yeah.
Email, storage, web services. He has to open some website, na?
Hmm.
Web services. And project related applications.
Okay.
Doing some project for that, you need an application. What is the application you need? For example, some testing software.
Okay,
you know, right? Some testing software you need, no? Simulator, something like that, related to project related. So, these all are the day to day, which is directly the user is using it, the end user is using it. So, these all information you have to collect. End of the day, the end user has to log in and work, right?
Yes.
He is not able to work means there is no use for us. So we need to collect the applications which is used by end user also. So all information you are collecting.
Yeah.
Do you understand this?
Yes, yeah, sir.
Now what are the things we left out in L3? Anything else we left out? IP addressing, routing protocols.
Okay, there are only routing. ICMP.
That is ping, na?
Yes.
RIP is also there. RIP is also there, see? RIP NG is there. BGP is there. Okay. Understand, na?
Yes, sir.
So this is your activity now. Now what I am going to do, I am going to give you this sheet today. Okay? You need to create a topology in your notebook. Okay. You can start drawing the topology. Open this. You are able to open this file in your system?
Wait, so you have emailed me, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Just a yes, I can open it.
Okay. Now what you do now? Start from creating one by one topology. Okay. Now, just a moment. I will send you these details. Now, can you open one Word file? Show running config. I'm sorry, not Word file. One device. Show running config. Can you see that the configurations? Like, for example, you're opening which one? You tell me.
I'm opening IPv4 NAT.
No, not NAT, device. NAT is not a device.
Means that R1, that one.
R1 you're opening?
Yeah, R1CE router.
R1CE router. Just a moment.
Next to the cloud. After that, IPv4 NAT is configured.
That one minute. Tell me the router name, host name.
Just a moment. It's not even open. Why is it not?
R1,
Yeah.
R1C router. Okay, understood. Okay, now you are opening that R1C router. Maximize CLI. Okay, enter. Show run. Okay. Now what you are understanding in this? First, start one by one. You see. The first thing, I am able to see clock time zone UTC 0. Mm-hmm. IPSF is configured. IPv6 unicast routing. So IPv6 is configured.
Yes.
I'm just seeing, like, you understand, right? I'm noting down all the points here. Then spanning tree is PVSTP is configured. And loopback 1 is configured and mentioned like this for testing purpose. For BGP routing, IP address is 1.1.1. And IP address is the IPv6 address also they configured, and IPv6 OSPF area is OSPF 6 area 12. Okay, version process 6 area 12. And they have interfaces like 1, 2, 3. Okay, now they have created sub interfaces. I think it is point to multi point. Point to point. Sub interface means point to point, right? In frame layer, two types is there, remember?
Yes, sir.
In that, they have done IP address this, then frame layer JLC number they are given, and OSPF they are configured in this. NAT they are configured, IPv6 they are configured. Then they told like what is the clock rate, you know? Then another one they created, that is a description of ISP router, frame relay, again that's also frame relay, JLC number 151, access group 30 in. So they have put some access list here, you know, IP NAT, then VLAN 1 is there, nothing configured, then OSPF 1. OSPF 1 router ID is 1.1.1, and they have configured authentication, you know, right? OSPF authentication they have done. Then network command default originate, okay. VGP also they configured, IPv6 they have configured, NAT they are configured, they made it classless. They have configured null route command. What is this null command, you know? Null zero.
Where is it, sir? Let's see.
After NAT command.
Means default.
Are you seeing my screen?
Yes, sir. Means the default.
Here. Are you seeing my screen?
Yes, sir.
I highlighted it.
Yeah. I think I know, sir, but I cannot recollect.
Okay, what you do is, I want you to go through this and note down all the commands. Take one configuration like this. Try to understand each and every word in this configuration. So run, ma'am.
Okay.
Right?
Yes, sir.
This will tell you a lot of idea about what is configured.
Yes.
And they configure NTP also. So this is called configuration audit. What we call this?
Configuration audit.
So now we are actually understanding each and everything what is configured in R1, R2, R3, R4. So slowly we will try to understand the topology.
Okay.
Right? Same way we go for a switch. Let us open one switch. This is I open R1. I am going to open now. What is the switch? It's ASW1. Access switch. Open core switch. Yeah, this is distribution switch. So there is no core is become router. Okay, let's see. I'll give here show run here also. I like to understand what is configured in this IP routing configured. So L3 switch, spanning tree motor RSTP configured, VLAN 20 priority they're given something. Okay, loopback they created, IPv6 configured, RIP is configured, IPv6 RIP is configured. You see that?
Yes, sir.
Port channel configured?
Yes.
Right, 22, 12, 23, Port channel. 19 channel group on all are given on. .20.2 19 20 21 22 23 24 24 may they have put RIP IPv6 right, then yeah. Gigabit ports are there. After gigabit ports we have VLAN. VLAN 10 they are called helper address, they are given, see. So they are using as this as a DHCP relay, and they have configured standby HSRP, they configured preempt, they configured. Understand now?
Yes.
Now, yeah, they configure NTP with proper authentication. Okay. NTP authentication, they given key also. Server IP they given. NTP, you know, right? Just no visa. Yes. All these things, the NTP also they configure. So is it clear now?
Yes.
Are you able to understand this?
Yes.
Like this, you go to each and every configuration and try to understand and create topology diagram. Okay. So next week, our task is we'll take first ticket. But before taking the ticket, I like to see this diagrams, what you create. I'll give this diagram. I have already created the diagrams. I'll share with you. But before that, I want you to sit and create this topology diagram like this.
This one or the one you have sent, sir?
No, this is the one. Same thing. What I said, no. This is the topology diagram.
Okay.
Understand or not?
Yes, sir.
Whatever I sent you, right?
Huh?
The topology diagram it is.
Okay.
Logical diagram. That is physical. This is logical diagram.
Okay.
R1, R2, R3, R4. Four routers are there, na?
Yes.
What is configured inside that? L3 information. Can you see that? One is not NSSA, one is OSPF, area 0, area 12, area 34. All information they are telling you.
Okay.
I am not sharing this diagram with you now. I want you to create this using that configurations. Do you understand?
Okay.
This same diagram, okay? This is IPv6 diagram.
Okay.
Our same topology IPv6.
Okay.
Now this is L2. Okay, these are four switches, na?
Yeah.
These four switches, how the four channels are created.
Okay.
Did you understand this? See, basically what they are trying to do is, they are actually creating three topology diagrams. One is IPv4, L3. One is IPv6, L3. Then L2.
Means IPv4, whatever IPv4 means configurations are the only...
IPv4, L2 means layer 3 topology diagram. L3 topology diagram.
IPv4 means layer 3, okay, separately there are.
Separately they are creating one topology diagram for IPv4 L3. Same way, IPv6 L3. So two diagrams they are creating for IPv6. IPv6 one diagram, IPv4 diagram for L3. L2 only one, right?
Yes.
There is no IPv4 IPv6 concept. So L2 one diagram. Remember, in L2 only frame delay will come.
Okay.
Understand, na?
Yes, sir.
See, I showed you the WAN, right? WAN comes under where? L2 or L3?
L2.
So L2, some diagram, some IP address they given us, that's why they put L3 also, because the server IP address is L3, na? They mention IP addresses also, no? Lot of places.
Yes.
So IP address is L3, that's why they mentioned L2, L3. But basically, this is L2, where some IP addresses are required to just to communicate, you know, HSRP, all these things.
Okay.
That's why they say L2, L3. Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
So this diagram you need to sit and yourself create. Okay, I will give you next week these diagrams before troubleshooting. But what I want you to do this week, whole week is there for you. Whenever you get time, just open this topology diagram, take a notebook and pen, open the show commands and write down whatever you can able to understand.
Okay.
Whatever you don't understand, Google search, find out. For example, null command is there, no? What is the null command? You just go and check it out. What is the null command? Just find out. Try to understand what is that, okay?
Okay.
Why they are configured. IP helper address, you know.
Yes.
Most of the things you may be knowing, whichever you don't know, you can ask me. Anyhow, next week, the first discussion will be discussing on these topology diagrams. Any doubts, I'll clear it out. Then I'll open the first ticket.
Okay.
We'll try to finish next week also. Next week itself, we'll finish the course, possible. Okay. Otherwise, one more week, I'll take it. Depends on your speed, okay?
Yes, sir.
Understand now?
Yes, sir.
I'll try to finish next week itself. Otherwise, you need to have more practice, then we'll take one more week.
Okay.
Maximum 2 weeks. Correct, na?
Yes, sir.
So total 15 tickets are there. I showed you only the working topology. From next week onwards, I'll start sharing the ticket one by one.
Okay.
One, two tickets. If I finish, I'll do all 15 tickets. You can one by one, you can do it and send it to me whenever you are getting time.
Okay, sir.
Clear, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You need more practice, you need to tell me, then we can take one more class extra if you want. Otherwise, I'll wind up with. If you are comfortable with troubleshooting yourself, then I'll wind up. Understood, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So first, to this week task is, please go through this topology diagram and try to create this topology, okay?
Okay, sir.
You understand, no? Then finish this known errors also.
Okay.
Known errors, one task. Second is what? Just creating the topology diagrams.
Okay.
This is this week homework. Try to finish. Otherwise, we'll see next week class. When we start the class, we'll do that. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So how was the class today?
Good, sir.
Okay, fine. So next week, we'll continue. Next week, I think it will be when is the class?
Yeah.
22nd. There are a task, I don't know. My problem is if I have corporate training, I need to, priority will go there only.
Okay.
You understand, no, I'm a corporate trainer. If yes. I get any corporate training now, so mm-hmm. They will send me to corporate training only. They will not allow me to teach. So next week, as of now, I don't have any corporate training. So morning 9:30 to we can keep it as 1 hour only, right? For you morning. Saturday is 1 hour only. Correct? Yeah.
Yes.
Sunday same. 7:30 to then.
So next Saturday we have a class, right, sir?
Yes, as of now, no problem. If any change, any new corporate training starts now, I'll update. 7:30 to 8:30, 1 hour, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we can do that. If any changes, I'll let you know. According to, as of now, there is no change. You can see my schedule, right? There's
yes.
no change in that. I have scheduled your name only.
Yes.
Okay, fine.
Okay.
Okay, then see you on next Saturday.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Take care. Bye.
Thank you. Bye, sir.
Kalyan.